guys. This is Jose from the Hooray for Jose podcast. I'm here at LA Comic Con with Mel Kylo.
What's up, Jose? How you doing?
Pretty good. How you doing?
I'm well. Good time here at LA Comic Con.
Yeah, it's so crowded on this Saturday, though.
Yeah, it's a good crowd. You know, they've built it up over the years. You know, it used to be called Kamikaze, then Stanley's Kamikaze. Now it's LA Comic Con. So I guess those people have just come to get used to an LA show.
Yeah, so how many of LA Comic Cons do you think you've come to?
I've been coming to this one since the very first one. Like, what, 7, 8 years ago when they had the first Kamikaze in the garage? It was like a garage wing of this convention center. I was like, oh my God, what the heck? It's in the garage. But it's gradually gotten better.
You work for Valiant.
Yes.
You do the marketing, right?
Director of marketing.
Director of marketing.
Yes.
All right. So for people who would want to get into this industry, what would be some of like the beginning steps? Like, what were some of the beginning steps that you had to go through to get to where you are right now?
Oh, wow. Yeah, I've been in comics industry for like almost 20 years. My first job in comics was working for a magazine called Wizard. And throughout the years, it's just, you know, getting to know the right people. And I'll be honest, don't be a dick. You know, if you're really nice to people, people remember who you are. And that's how I got this job here at Valiant, because I used to work for a guy at Wizard 20 years ago. 7 months ago, he was looking for a new marketing guy, because he remembered, you know, me. And I guess I never really, you know, said anything or did anything bad, you know, never burned those bridges, man. He came and asked me if I wanted to apply, and I said sure, and that's how I got it. And I've worked for Boom Studios, worked for Arkea, I worked for Top Cow over the years, and it's just a matter of being nice to everyone you meet and going out there and making yourself available, and you know, just showing your skills and telling, just showing how good a person you are, and that's how you get. I think it's how you succeed in every facet of life. Just being a good person, and don't be too controversial, and I think you'll be fine.
Yeah, I can definitely agree with that. Definitely with not burning your bridges, even if like you do move past certain things, like different careers, you're moving from different avenues. It's always good to still keep in touch with people, yes. You know, do like little favors like here and there, you know, yes. keep face. It's really important with that. So I think with any kind of entertainment, it's pretty much the same like basis. Or
it's true. It's true. You know, you build these relationships and they turn out to be pretty long lasting, and sometimes they can work in your favor. And that's how it's been for me in comics and in this space in general. You know, I've just known a lot of people over the years. I've met a lot of people over the years, and I've been able to parlay that into work.
So have you always been like a big fan of comics, or was it a thing that kind of started like later?
I was a late bloomer. I didn't start reading comics until after I got into college. So I started reading comics when Image was first formed, when the first Valiant was formed in 89, early 90s. I started out reading X-Men, Uncanny X-Men, and Teen Titans, and all that stuff in the early 90s. And I started buying back issues, wanted to complete my collection, and that's how I got really into it. It's just because, you know, I had friends who were into it, and they got me into it. And then I just, before you knew it, I was at the comic shop every Wednesday buying comics. And then I've just always loved that medium. And getting to work for Wizard Magazine in 1998 just was like the full circle, you know, wish fulfillment. I became a fan of comics, and then all of a sudden I'm working in the comic industry, so it's been great.
So, in a way, this is kind of like a dream job, where you're like, I love comics, and now I'm with them, like 24/7.
I cannot begin to tell you how awesome it is to get paid to pimp out comics, basically to spread the gospel of comics to people who are comics fans and also who are not really, you know, familiar with comics. Mm. And you know, I just like being able to spread that message and showing them good stories and, you know, awesome artists and characters that we work with. And that's my job. You know, I'm an evangelist. I pimp out comics to people and get them to pay attention to our books. And it's great because, you know, especially when you love the product, like the stuff that Valiant does, it's easy. And I get paid to do this every day, so it's great.
See that? I think that's like perfect. And from what I've seen when you've like been working these things, you're actually a pretty good like kind of like teacher for people who don't really know too much. You're like, oh, you know, if you're into this kind of style, you might like something like this.
Oh yeah, you have to. You have to find that in every time when you're talking to someone who doesn't know your company or doesn't know your characters or your books. You try to find some kind of parallel. You find out like what kind of genre story or like what kind of TV or movies they're watching. And we usually have a story that can match that kind of taste. And after you get them through the door, so to speak, I think pretty good chance that we'll hook them on other stories that Valiant publishes. So it's just a matter of finding them that perfect gateway comic based on the kind of things they like, their tastes, and you know what they enjoy.
See, and that's why you do what you do, because you know what you're talking about. That's the thing. And the thing is, like, that's why I wanted to do this too, because usually on the other side, getting people to do interviews.
Yeah.
So how does it feel like now to be the one getting interviewed?
It's a little uncomfortable. I don't usually do the interviews. I'm the one who's setting up the interviews for our different creators, our different editors and stuff. I don't usually do interviews myself because I think, like, who cares what I think? Who cares what I have to say? But, you know, you insisted. Here I am talking to you about what I do for a living. Hopefully there's maybe one person out there who's interested.
Well, I think Kevin Smith said it best on one of his shows, that everyone thinks that, like, who's going to want to listen to me? But there's going to be somebody who's going to be interested in what you have to say.
That's a good point. I guess I have to adopt that policy or that sentiment. But yes, it's true. You're right. You know, there's probably some people out there who are interested or curious about how to get a job in marketing and comics. And obviously, it's go to school, you know, graduate, get a degree, and make yourself known to some of these people. You know, go to conventions, make friends with creators, go out to the bars after hours and whatnot. You know, once you get to know the right people, some jobs will come looking for you.
Yeah, and sometimes it's when you least expect it too. You're sitting down somewhere, just talking to someone, all of a sudden there's someone from a big company, you're like, I didn't know, and I was being myself, was nervous, just that. I think that's some of the best, like, non-recorded interviews that could possibly happen, where you're just talking to someone, having a good conversation and stuff.
That's true. That's how life is sometimes, you know? It's the school of life. You know, you learn from experiences every day, from the new relationships you make, the people you meet. And that can definitely, you know, that can definitely help, you know, steer your path and guide you to hopefully what you think would be a good job or a good dream career for you.
Awesome. And before we go, which one of these comics from Valiant would you recommend to anybody, like beginner or somebody who's in it?
For someone who has not read Valiant at all, but is curious to start, I would recommend a book called The Valiant. It's called The Valiant, and it's a storyline that features cameos from almost all the major characters in the Valiant universe. And I think that it would be a good jumping off point for people to get a taste of what kind of character, or who these characters are, and then if they want to learn more or read more stories about that character, there's most likely a book related to them, like Bloodshot, like Exo Man of War, like The Eternal Warrior. They're all in this story, and it's one self-contained story in one trade paperback. I would recommend The Valiant.
Well, there you go, guys. Thanks again. It's great talking to you. I know I surprised you into this, but
yeah.
I like that. What do you think? Good? Yes? No?
No, it's fine. You know, I hate the sound of my own voice. So I probably won't listen to this interview or look at it, but I'm glad to do it. Glad you were interested in talking to me.
Oh, always. That's what I love to do. I love talking to everybody.
All right. Thanks, Jose.
Thank you. Thanks, guys.